Good morning to all. Today we are going to start off with the third session of the chapter, that is word processing. In this chapter, we'll try to learn some new features of Microsoft Word 2010 version. So I'll just move on to the book first of all. Here it is, session 3, that is identify the elements of user interface. Now, first of all, Windows is a GUI based operating system. GUI is graphical user interface. What this means that you can use a mouse to give commands just by clicking or pointing in the icons or selecting certain items from the menu. Right, we don't have to type the commands for getting the things done. Right, if you talk about the earlier versions of operating systems, the purane versions the, there we used to type commands for whatever we want to do. Right, but in case of Windows, it is graphical user interface based operating system where things are all given in the form of certain options. We just have to click or point on those options using our mouse. So it's easy for us to use. Now, just to start with this, we need to understand certain important features, how we are going to start. So I'll start up with this. The very first thing is, what are the components of the Microsoft Word window? Right? As you see on the top, we have a lot of options, and these options comes under a single area, which is called as a ribbon. In this ribbon, we have all sort of different options, which comes under different tabs and groups and all, right? So this area is the ribbon area. And on the right corner, top corner, we have three buttons, which are window controls, from where we can minimize, restore, and close an application. Then, of course, we have some help menu, help option. Again, in the right top corner, you can find a question mark symbol at the corner just below this cross close button option. Then on the top, we have the title bar, and title bar is generally used to show the title of the page. And it's generally written over here, the name of the software, that is Microsoft Word, plus the name of the file that you have opened. And if you haven't saved it, it will give you the name document 1, 2, 3, etc. And again, just next to the title bar, we'll have a small bar over here, which is called as Quick Access Toolbar. And what is the use of this toolbar? It contains certain options which are more frequently used in Word, right? Like save button is there, undo redo button is there, new file option is there. And there's a small arrow from where you can add more number of options over here. So like if you want to add print command over here. So from this arrow, just select print, or print button will be added. And from there, you can directly go with the print option. Then these are called as tabs, as we see here, file, home, insert, page layout. These are all different tabs, and every tab has got certain group of options. As you see at the bottom of every the ribbon, you'll find the names written. These are basically your groups, like clipboard group is there, font group is there, paragraph is there, style is there, editing is there. And in every group, we have certain options related to that particular group. Like in font group, we have all sort of options with the help of which we can format the font of a document, right? So, and every group has a small icon on the right side. Like if you see paragraph ke side mein chota sa icon hai, we'll also have the icon on the font group. We also have the icon on clipboard. These icons are called as dialog box launcher. We have last time bhi kiya tha. When you click on this small icon, the advanced features and more features of this particular group, like this is paragraph, so we'll get more options related to paragraph in a separate dialog box, right? So then on the top, we also have a ruler bar, and this is vertical horizontal ruler, and here it is vertical ruler. And then there's a small icon in this corner, in the right corner, from where you can simply view the ruler, or if you want to hide the ruler, you can just click on this, it will hide the ruler, right? So, and then we have a scroll bar, again vertical and horizontal. This is vertical scroll bar and this is the horizontal scroll bar. This is generally used to move the page up and down or left or right. And this white area is called as document area, for where we type. And this blinking line from where we start typing. Whenever we start typing, start from the blinking line, which is called as a cursor. Right? At the bottom, you'll find a status bar, which shows you the status of the page. And it shows you various options related to various things. Like if you click on the page, you'll get the number of pages on the left corner, like page 101 is written. Right, so it will give you the number of pages. It also give you the word count, right? And some more options are there. We'll do it one by one later on. And then we have a view toolbar. View toolbar is just to open this document in different forms, right? We have different kind of views. Basically, views are different kind of forms in which we can open this particular document. And on the right side, we'll have zoom toolbar, from where we can zoom the page, zoom in and zoom out, both options are there. Fine. Now, as I have told you, title bar displays the name of the document and the name of the program, the software. And on the left side, we have quick access toolbar. And there are three group buttons just to manage the window. This quick access toolbar, or QAT, it has certain frequently used commands like save, undo, redo, print is there. We can add up more if we want to. Then talking about file tab on the top, now it displays all file management tasks. It like opening a file, saving a file, printing a file, publishing, sharing a file. So if you want to open all already saved files, we can go with that. See, if you talk, as you see, this is the file option on the left corner. But if you talk about the previous version, like in 2007 version, this is 2010 version. In 2007 version, we don't have file tab. There we have office button, a round kind of button. And when you click on that round button, we'll get all these options. Opening a file, saving file, printing, publishing, sharing. These all file management task options are there. Ribbon, I told you, tabs. Now these are different tabs which are there. The first tab is the file tab, where we have options like new, open, save, print, close. Home tab is there. In place of this file tab, in older versions, in 7, that's 2007, mein office button hota hai. Home tab mein clipboard group hai, font hai, paragraph, styles, editing hai. Insert tab mein, these are all options are there. Likewise. So we'll do all these options one by one. Let's go with the home tab first of all. Now home tab is very important tab, and it contains the most options for editing and formatting a document. If you want to change something on the document, or if you want to format the design or the text of the document, all options lies in this home tab. Isme jo sabse pehla group hai, that is clipboard group. In this clipboard group, it is used to store the data temporarily to transfer it internally or externally in a document. So basically it has cut, copy, paste options, from where when you copy certain things in a document, what happens is the data is copied to a place called as clipboard, right? And then when you paste it, it is pasted from that clipboard to that particular location where you have pasted. तो क्लिपबोर्ड एक ऐसा एरिया होता है जहां पे जो भी कुछ आप कॉपी या कट करते हो वो उस क्लिपबोर्ड में पहले कॉपी होगा जब आप पेस्ट करोगे फिर वो क्लिपबोर्ड से उठा के उसको पेस्ट करेगा। अगर आपने कट किया है तो क्लिपबोर्ड में से वो रिमूव हो जाएगा या प्रीवियस लोकेशन से रिमूव हो जाएगा। कॉपी किया है तो देन इट विल क्रिएट अ न्यू कॉपी ऑफ दैट सेम डेटा, राइट? सो दीज आर द थ्री ऑप्शंस, कट, कॉपी, पेस्ट। हियर दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज समटाइम क्वेश्चन इज आस्क्ड कि भाई हाउ डू वी मूव अ डेटा एंड हाउ डू वी कैन और व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन मूविंग अ डेटा एंड क्रिएटिंग अ कॉपी ऑफ इट। मूविंग इज डन विद द हेल्प ऑफ कट पेस्ट ऑप्शन एंड कॉपी इज जस्ट टू क्रिएट अ कॉपी ऑफ इट। ठीक है, मूव करना मतलब आप एक जगह से कट करो और दूसरी जगह पे पेस्ट करो, दैट इज मूविंग अ डॉक्यूमेंट। ठीक है, द डॉक्यूमेंट और द टेक्स्ट और द डेटा, तो जो भी आपने टाइप किया है, और इफ यू हैव अ पिक्चर समवेयर, इफ यू वांट टू रिमूव दैट पिक्चर फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट प्रीवियस लोकेशन एंड यू वांट टू कॉपी दैट सेम थिंग टू और मूव दैट सेम थिंग टू अ न्यू प्लेस, तो आप कट पेस्ट ऑप्शन यूज करो। अगर आपको दोनों जगह पे वो पिक्चर चाहिए तो कॉपी पेस्ट ऑप्शन यूज करो। नेक्स्ट इज फॉर्मेट प्रिंटर। नाउ फॉर्मेट प्रिंटर इज अ वेरी यूजफुल टूल इन डॉक्यूमेंट। सी फॉर्मेट प्रिंटर का मतलब है कि जो भी टेक्स्ट फॉर्मेट किसी पर्टिकुलर डॉक्यूमेंट में है, इफ यू वांट टू अप्लाई दैट सेम फॉर्मेट टू सम अदर टेक्स्ट, जैसे मान लो टॉप पे एक हेडिंग है माई स्कूल, ठीक है, अब उसका फॉर्मेट आपने सेट किया जी, उसको बोल्ड कर दिया, उसका साइज 18 कर दिया, उसका कलर रेड कर दिया, उसका राइटिंग स्टाइल आपने चेंज कर दिया, कर्सिव राइटिंग ले ली, राइट, या कोई और फॉन्ट स्टाइल ले लिया। नाउ इफ यू वांट टू अप्लाई द सेम सेटिंग्स टू सम अदर लाइन इन द टेक्स्ट, यू वांट कि भाई लास्ट में देयर इज अ टेक्स्ट रिटन एज कॉन्टेक्ट, इफ यू वांट टू अप्लाई द सेम सेटिंग्स फ्रॉम दैट पर्टिकुलर the heading to that context text, so उसके लिए हम format painter option use करते हैं। ठीक है, I'll just show you this how this happens. Sorry, just a second, I'll take up the attendance because अभी काफी बच्चे आए हुए हैं। Okay, that's it. So I'll move on to Word. Let me open one new Word document first of all. Now I have 2007 version, so that file tab is not available here. Anyhow, rest all options are same. Now let's say there's a text written here, my school, right? Now I am just applying certain settings for formatting features over here. I'm increasing the size, I'm making it bold, right? And then making it italics, changing the color or highlighting it, right? So and there's another text at the end of the page or anywhere, like I'll just move down a bit, right? Now I want the same formatting settings over here. मुझे यहाँ पे भी ऐसा ही format चाहिए, तो एक तरीका तो यह है, you again go to all settings, जैसे हमने italics किया था, हमने size किया था, साइज यहाँ से देखो 22 है तो यहाँ पे साइज 22 सेट करो और चेंज द कलर, मेक इट हाईलाइट। सो दिस इज वन वे। सेकंड वे इज द इजीएस्ट वे इज फॉर्मेट प्रिंटर। यू कैन सी दिस फॉर्मेट प्रिंटर ऑप्शन ओवर हियर एंड द कीबोर्ड शॉर्टकट इज कंट्रोल शिफ्ट सी, राइट? सो यू जस्ट क्लिक एनीवेयर बिटवीन दिस पर्टिकुलर टेक्स्ट, द टेक्स्ट जहाँ से आपको फॉर्मेट उठाना है, क्लिक ऑन दिस फॉर्मेट प्रिंटर। नाउ द मोमेंट यू कम टू दिस डॉक्यूमेंट, आपका जो कर्सर है वो चेंज हो जाएगा, एज यू कैन सी स्मॉल ब्रश काइंड ऑफ सिंबल देयर, जो कर्सर माउस कर्सर पे। नाउ क्लिक ऑन दिस, ड्रैग योर माउस फॉर सेलेक्टिंग एंड लीव इट। द मोमेंट यू लीव द सेम सेटिंग इज अप्लाइड ओवर हियर. ये फॉर्मेट सेटिंग है, फॉर्मेट प्रिंटर का काम है, राइट. So this is format, cut, copy, paste options are easy. People already have done so much, so I'm not covering up that. Then talking about font group. In the font group, we have font face, size, color, bold, italics, underline, strike through the selected text, superscript, subscript, change the case or highlight the text. Okay, chalo, I'll give you some small demo of things. As you see in the font group, from here we can change the writing style, from here we can change the size, you can increase the font size or decrease the font size and make it bold or italics or underline it, right. And this is the strike through option. Strike through make line aa jati hai text ke beech mein. If you want to show it, you can use it. And this is your superscript and subscript option. Superscript is like if you want the text to be written like this, I want to write H2O, the formula, water. So just select this two and go with this subscript option. The two jo hai wo text jo hai no thoda niche ho jayega. Right, so ऐसे ही likewise, and if you want to write 2 to the power 3, so write 3, select it and click on this, right. Remember we have to again click to remove this option, otherwise वो ऊपर power वाले option में ही लिखता जाएगा, ठीक है. ये subscript हो गया, superscript हो गया. Then if you want to change from small to capitals, like this is the sentence case. We have 5 types of cases here. This is the sentence case where first letter is capital and rest all are small. You can make it lower mein ye sare ke sare small letters mein ho jayenge, fine. And upper mein all are capitals. Sentence bhi main dikha deta hu, first letter capital, rest all small. Then capitalize each word. This works with the sentence. Right, I write sentence case, so it first letter is capital, baki har word jitne bhi words hain sab small mein ho jayenge, aur capitalize each word mein har word ka first letter capital hoga. Toggle case mein opposite ho jayega, first letter is small, rest all is capital. If you want to use it, you can use this also. And this is the highlight option. Ab select karo text ko and then you can highlight. And highlight ke saath mein chota sa arrow hai from where you can change the color of the highlighted background. Right? So you can choose whatever color you want to apply. Right? So highlighting can be done, and from here we can change the color of the text that we have typed. Right, so select the things first, click on this color that will be applied. Right, let's see what all things are there now. After this we have paragraph group. Isme bullet hai, number hai, multi level list hai, increase decrease indents hai, alignment options are there, and spacing, line spacing options are there. Then background color if you want to apply, borders if you want to change or customize, then sorting anything in alphabetical order or numerical order, then markups if you want to add, then we have styles group in which we can put up certain titles, certain codes, such kind of styles are there. You can just choose any styles that you want, and within one style we can also change the format of a style by changing the color code of the style or font of the style that can we can change, right. So इसके जो भी फीचर्स हैं दे विल बी कवर्ड अप इन द लेटर पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर्स, जो जो इम्पोर्टेंट हमारे सिलेबस में है विल कवर अप दैट. सो आई एम जस्ट गोइंग थ्रू इट, आई एम नॉट गिविंग इन एवरीथिंग इन डिटेल. सो जो जो ऑप्शन हमारे इम्पोर्टेंट सिलेबस में है विल कवर अप इट इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. सो स्टाइल्स मैं बता देता हूँ बिकॉज स्टाइल्स वॉज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, इट कम्स इन बोर्ड एग्जाम लास्ट ईयर ऑल्सो. तो स्टाइल्स में मैं दिखा देता हूँ तुम लोग को स्टाइल्स क्या है. एज यू सी ओवर हेयर ऑन द टॉप वी हैव स्टाइल्स ग्रुप इन द होम टैब. यहाँ पे कुछ रेडीमेड स्टाइल्स हैं. नो दीज स्टाइल्स आर बेसिकली जैसे हम इफ यू टॉक अबाउट पावर पॉइंट, इन पावर पॉइंट वी हैव योर रेडीमेड डिजाइन दैट यू कैन अप्लाई टू एनी स्लाइड. द सेम वे वी हैव लॉट ऑफ रेडीमेड डिजाइन दैट यू कैन अप्लाई वेयर फॉर्मेटिंग इज ऑलरेडी डन. लाइक इफ यू सेलेक्ट दिस, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू टू सेलेक्ट द टेक्स्ट, I'll select this one, go to styles, click on that particular format. If you want to apply this, if you want to apply this, so whatever you want to apply, just click on that. That font, everything is applied. And if you want to change this, you can go with this change styles option. From here, you can change the style. And these are the same options that you see on the top, right? And apart from this, we can change the color schemes. Now this is blue by default, and if you want to change the color, right, so colors can be changed, schemes can be applied, fine. And similarly, we can also change the font schemes. You can see the font is also changing. So ये कुछ रेडीमेड स्टाइल्स हैं विच कैन मेक योर टेक्स्ट मोर अट्रैक्टिव एंड ईजी फॉर यूज, राइट. सो दैट्स ऑल अबाउट स्टाइल्स. आई विल कम बैक. देन एंड देयर इज एन एडिटिंग टैब वेयर वी कैन यूज दिस फाइंड एंड रिप्लेस ऑप्शन. दिस इज क्वाइट इम्पॉर्टेंट ऑप्शन इन डॉक्यूमेंट बिकॉज इट हेल्प अस टू फाइंड सर्टन वर्ड इन द फुल डॉक्यूमेंट. And if you want to replace one word with some other word, so we have an option over here. And then selection of text and objects, there's an option for that. Status bar, maine bataya, it displays the page and line number. It also displays the word count, how many words are there in that document, how many words you have typed. Right, and the proof button is there on the left side. On the right side, we have some display buttons. This has shown you that there is a zoom in zoom out option, and then there is a view tab from where you can change the view of the document. Views mein hota hai ki jaise full screen view hai jahan pe aapke options jo hain wo hide ho jayenge, aapka document sirf full screen form mein aa jayega, right. So likewise things can be easily done. So scroll bars to move the page up and down or left to right if the page is larger than the normal size of the window. Rulers, we have two, horizontal and vertical, and it is useful to just see the size of the page, and you can even find the center quite easily by using that ruler, right. The positionings can be done. Window control mein ye minimize, restore ya maximize button or close button, teen button hai. ठीक है, मिनिमाइज बटन इज टू रिड्यूस दिस विंडो इनटू दिस टास्क बार, ये नीचे आ जाएगी. रीस्टोर से अगर आपने उसको छोटा किया है, राइट, इफ यू हैव रीस्टोर, इफ यू क्लिक ऑन रीस्टोर दैट विंडो विल, द साइज ऑफ द विंडो विल श्रिंक, एंड इफ यू अगेन क्लिक इट, इट विल गो टू द मैक्सिमम साइज और मैक्सिमम साइज, तो फुल स्क्रीन मोड में वो चला जाता है. Close button say we can close the current application, right. Now we'll do all these options one by one in different sessions. Now in session 4 we have how do we format a document. It's in bold, italics, underline or certain more options are there. Now the very first thing is what is formatting. Formatting is, it means the changing the appearance of the text. Now why do we do it? to make our text more attractive so that users can easily see the things, they can easily understand the things. Now, if you want to send a document to somebody and your format is not up to the mark, so the person will be finding it, he will find difficult to open it, right, or difficult to understand the things. So it's always better if we do proper formatting so that the text that we send can be easily understood by anybody, right? So this is an important option. Now, how do we do this formatting? Now, we can change the style of writing, we can change the size, color, and alignment. All these options we have just seen, right? So we have this font option, from where we can change the font. From here, we can change the size. This is to increase the font, and this is to decrease the font. It is called as grow font and shrink font option. From here, we can change the case. This is font color, highlighting, text effects, superscript, subscript, strike through, underline, italics, and bold. So these all options we have just seen, right? This is bold, italics, underline option. You can see here, bold, normal text, thoda sa bold hota hai, thoda sa thicker hota hai, jo letter hai. Italics may leans to one side, and underline may will have a line at the bottom. See, these shortcuts are very important. It's given in the book everywhere. So in TechBytes, you can see keyboard shortcuts of bold is Control B, for italics it is Control I, and to underline we use Control U. So ye shortcuts zarur karna, because isme ye questions, one mark questions bahut aate hain shortcuts ke based pe, right? Then these are some of the exercises. Now we come to check spelling and grammar. Now, word processor softwares, all sort of word processing softwares, they have these options to check the spellings and grammars errors in a document. If you want to check the spelling, like if, now by default, it automatically, the software automatically checks it. Jab bhi aap type karte ho, saath saath check karta jata hai. Wherever it finds any error in the words or the spellings of the word, it will give a red wavy line at the bottom. And if there is a grammatical error, like if you can see, ye niche red lines hai, iska matlab ye sare spelling errors hai. And if there is a green wavy line, then that is, it's having a grammatical error, grammar error is there. The word spellings are okay, but the thing, grammar errors are there, right? One more option is also their blue line, which is not turned on by default, usko hume on karna padta hai. Or that this also indicates the spelling errors. It indicates the contextual spelling errors, and that is the, these error means that the word has been wrongly used by the, but spelled correctly. The word is wrongly taken up, but the spelling is okay, right? So if the word is wrongly taken up and then that blue line comes, fine. So now how do we do this? Now, there are two ways to check the spellings or correct the spellings. One is if you go to review tab, and you'll find spelling and grammar option here. This is the symbol, as you can see, ABC and tick written over here. Fine. So you can use this option. Just click on this. The moment you click on, we'll get this interface. And in this interface, you just have to see. It will automatically keep on checking, and it will indicate all sort of errors that it comes. That it checks that is my word ke spelling wrong hai. So yahan pe niche suggestions deta hai wo. You can replace this word with what kind of words. So we can replace this word itself is wrong, uski jagah pe hum ye words dal sakte hain. And if you find, like if you talk about Indian words or words that are based on our language, Hindi, some Hindi words we generally use in typing sometimes. Like if I want to type my name, Gaurav. So that Gaurav word is a Hindi word, which is not part of your English lesson. So it will give an error of whenever we type this. So ye words hamare hisab se sahi hain, but wo indicate karta hai errors ko. Now, we have options over here. Either we want to change or ignore it. Like if I'm talking about Gaurav, Gaurav word is okay. But if you want to ignore it, then click on this ignore once or ignore all. What are these two options? Ignore once is if that Gaurav word is there 10 times in one page. And if you want to click, if you click ignore once, so वो एक जगह पे जहां पे भी उसने पहली बार उस वर्ड को पिक किया है एट दैट लोकेशन दैट वर्ड इज इग्नोर्ड नॉट एट अदर लोकेशंस राइट सो इफ यू वांट टू इग्नोर ऑल लोकेशंस वेयर दैट वन सिंगल वर्ड इज लाइक आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट दैट गौरव गौरव वर्ड अगर 10 बार है हमें वो 10 के 10 में इग्नोर करना है तो हम इग्नोर ऑल पे जाएंगे अगर आपको एक ही जगह पे इग्नोर करना है विल गो विद इग्नोर वंस ठीक है सिमिलर इज द केस विद चेंज एंड चेंज ऑल सो इफ यू वांट टू चेंज दिस रॉन्ग वर्ड विद अ न्यू वर्ड फ्रॉम द सजेशंस देन क्लिक ऑन चेंज और चेंज ऑल द सेम इज द डिफरेंस दैट इफ यू क्लिक ऑन चेंज तो वो एक ही बार चेंज करेगा अगर वो वर्ड 10 बार आता है तो बाकी जगह पे चेंज नहीं होगा एंड इफ यू क्लिक ऑन चेंज ऑल तो सब जगह पे वो जो वर्ड है everywhere wherever that word is there in that document that will be replaced by a new word given in the suggestion right and there are few more options like if you want to add a new word to the dictionary so we can click on this add to dictionary isse kya hoga ke in case dobara wo word dobara aata hai jaise we were talking about that gaurav word as per our idea it is right so we'll add that word into the dictionary so next time whenever that word occurs or comes in the document it will not identify it as an error agli baar wo error ki tarah count nahi karega usko right to ye to ho gaya change all option or ignore all option add to dictionary so ye work kaise karta hai wo ek ek karke sare errors ko indicate karta jayega and once you are done with this जैसे फर्स्ट वर्ड आया व्हेन यू क्लिक ऑन इग्नोर और चेंज दैट इट विल आइडेंटिफाई द नेक्स्ट वर्ड उसके बारे में यहाँ पे इंफॉर्मेशन आएगी एंड इफ यू वांट टू इट कीप्स ऑन चेकिंग एंड कीप्स ऑन गिविंग यू सजेशंस सो वंस ऑल आर डन देन विल गेट दिस मैसेज ऑन द स्क्रीन वर्ड फिनिश्ड चेकिंग दिस सिलेक्शंस नाउ डू यू वांट टू कंटिन्यू द चेकिंग रिमाइंडर्स फॉर द डॉक्यूमेंट इफ यू क्लिक यस तो इट विल अगेन स्टार्ट चेकिंग इफ यू क्लिक ऑन नो तो चेकिंग पार्ट विल बी ओवर राइट राइट तो यस करने से दोबारा से चेकिंग शुरू हो जाएगी नो करने से आपको ये फाइनल मैसेज आएगा स्पेलिंग एंड ग्रामर चेक इज कंप्लीट राइट सो दिस इज वन वे ऑफ फाइंडिंग द एरर्स और ग्रामर एरर्स और योर स्पेलिंग एरर्स सो अनदर वे इज दैट द सिंपलर वे नाउ इफ यू हैव लेस नंबर ऑफ एरर्स इन अ डॉक्यूमेंट सो वी कैन ऑल्सो गो विद राइट क्लिक जैसे ये इधर दिया है नेटवर्क के स्पेलिंग रॉन्ग है व्हेन यू क्लिक ऑन दिस वर्ड विल गेट अ लिस्ट ऑफ ऑल सॉर्ट ऑफ सजेशंस हियर इसके बारे में आपको राइट सजेशन आ जाएगा कि इसकी जगह पे ये वर्ड आ सकता है और नीचे इग्नोर ऑल एंड ऑल ऑप्शंस आर देयर राइट सो दिस इज ऑल्सो वन वे ऑफ करेक्टिंग ऑल द एरर्स सो आप राइट क्लिक करो अगर आपका सजेशन सही लगता है सेलेक्ट दैट और इग्नोर ऑप्शन में जाके इग्नोर कर दो ठीक है So this is also one way of identifying and correcting the errors, right? Then again, next thing is about your grammar check. Now, same thing happens over here. जैसे आपका misspelled words थे, red underlines, वैसे ही green underlines and same options are there. Ignore once, ignore all, then change. If you want to change this. And again, we have suggestion box where the suggestions are given by the software. कि इस word की जगह पे यहाँ पे क्या आना चाहिए, right? तो यहाँ पे wires is rightly written, but the only there may be some grammatical error. Like if you type is some one at one place where r should come, तो वो grammar error है. तो इस की जगह पे r आना था, वो grammar error है. तो ऐसे indications वो आपको देगा. And again, we have the same option. Right click on the word which has some error. वहाँ पे आपको suggestions or ignore once option मिलेगा. So we can ignore that particular word, right? So that's it from my side today. So I'll end up here now. We are left with only 1 minute. So the lesson is going to be over. I think more number of students have joined. So be there before that. I'll take up attendance once again. बच्चे और भी आ गए हैं. Now, if you people have any doubt, you can definitely ask. Fine. And that's all from my side today.